everyone. Welcome to Fortify Unplugged. Today I would like to showcase the Fortify On Demand Jenkins Plugin 7.0. To get this version of the plugin, you need to go to Manage Jenkins and Plugin Manager. Under the updates, you can search for the word Fortify. If you have a previously installed version of Jenkins Fortify On Demand plugin, you will see the 7.0 version come up under updates. If you don't have a previous version installed, you will see that under the Available tab. Once you download and successfully install the plugin, you can go to the Installed tab and look for the Fortify On-Demand plugin installed. You can always click on this link to open the documentation to review all the new cool features. Now let's look at the setup. Before we start on setting up the project, we need to set up a configuration at the system level. Once you are in the system configuration, there is a new setting for setting up the Scan Central. Scan Central is a lightweight tool that we suggest our customers to use for packaging their payload for successful scanning with Fortify On Demand. You can find the Scan Central client under Fortify On Demand portal tools page. You can download the zip file, unzip the zip file and place it in a location where Jenkins can access and provide the path to the bin folder here. Once you have the path specified, you can apply and save and you are all set to be ready to go. Now let's go to the dashboard and go to the projects. For today's demo's purposes, I have two different projects set up here, one for the freestyle and one is pipeline. Let's look at the freestyle project and see what is new. Let's go to the configuration. Under the freestyle configuration, under the post build action, you will find Fortify On Demand static assessment action. Please, you need to enable the action to see all the options for setting up your pipeline for submitting the scan to Fortify On Demand. One of the new options that has been introduced in 7.0 is applications and releases option. By selecting this option, now you will be able to set up an application, microservice, and release for your project to be used for running your scans. So to do that, you can select an existing application that the user has access to, or you can create a new application. If you want to create a new application, you can click on the create and enter all the information. You can even create a new microservice or new release under an existing application. Once you're on the screen, owner ID is a required field. So if you are a user using a personal access token to authenticate to the Fortify On Demand, you will see this assign me button to assign the application automatically to that user. If you are using API key secret, you will need to provide the user owner ID for this application to be associated with. Once you have the information filled out, you can click on the add button and we dynamically generate the application and the release for you. Moving on to the scan settings. On the scan settings section, we have introduced a new scan setting for Scan Central integration. If you want to use Scan Central for packaging your payload, you need to pick an option other than none. It could be any of these popular build tools, Maven, Gradle, or MS Build, or any of your Python and PHP projects. If you select none, you will be able to still submit all your payloads picking a technology stack that is relevant for your project. When you pick any of the Scan Central options, you will be provided with the set of parameters to fill in if there is a specific build command or a build file that you would like to specify to build your project. For more further details on each of these fields, please refer to the Scan Central documentation, which is available in your README text file in the Scan Central folder. For an MS Build option, a build file is a required field and you need to provide the solution file name with the dot extension of the solution. Once you have all this information filled out, you can click apply and save, and now you have your project set up. Also, I would like to mention you can submit an open source scan as well as part of the static assessment. And also you can set up a post-build polling action for you to poll the scan to know when the scan gets done. Today I have a, for demo purpose, I have a Gradle project that I have set up. Let's go ahead and build this project. Let's review the console output. As you can see here, the Jenkins has been set up to use my Git repo for downloading the source for the Gradle project. And once it downloads, it runs the it builds my project using the installed version of Gradle that is accessible to the Jenkins, and also it packages the payload using Scan Central. The output of the package is shown here. And also, if you want to refer to the logs for the Scan Central, it's located in this directory. As you can see, this was a small project and it was successfully built, and also was scan was uploaded to FOD. And this is the scan ID for this scan. Now let's look at the pipeline project. For Jenkins pipeline project, let's go to the configuration. As you can see here, this is a Groovy script that I have generated using a pipeline syntax editor. Let's click on the pipeline syntax and look at the Fortify on-demand setup options. Under the sample steps, you can select Fortify on-demand static assessment, and that populates all the specific options for Fortify on-demand. Under the release section, you will see a new option for auto provision. This is a new option that has been introduced in 7.0, which is similar to the application and release option in the freestyle project, where you can specify the application name, if it is a microservice, or the release name, and you can fill in all this information. If the application or the release that has been specified here does not exist in the tenant portal for that tenant, we will go ahead and create the new application for that customer. As you can see here, under the scan options, there is a new option for Scan Central build type. It works exactly like the freestyle project, which has the same drop-down items. You can select the Scan Central for packaging your payload, or if you don't want to choose Scan Central, you can always choose none and pick the technology stack you would like to submit your payload under. Once you have all this information filled in, and you can generate the pipeline script, and you can copy the script and paste it into your configuration for this pipeline. Once you have your configuration all set up, you can go ahead and run this pipeline. I have my pipeline here set up for MS Build project. Let's go ahead and run this pipeline. While the pipeline is building, let's go ahead and look at the console output. As you can see, similar to the freestyle project, you can see that it is accessing my Git repo, which has the source, and it is building the, it is using MS Build to build my project. And it was able to build successfully, and also the output of the output zip file is located under this location in the Jenkins workspace. And also there is a Scan Central log for if you want to review. The scan was successfully submitted, and this is the scan ID. If you have a polling enabled for this pipeline, then the pipeline will wait for the scan to finish and report the status of the scan along with the findings. Thank you very much for watching this video. Hope this was helpful.